this, we're trying to throw some more lifestyle stuff into our podcast here. So I thought I would start with mine and share some of the up and downs that we go through as a professional creative entrepreneur. We started our year off well. I hope you started your year off well here when we're taping this. We're into March already. And, you know, we started our year off really well because we went to Barbados. We spend our winters in the Caribbean. We leave mid-December, come back around the end of January, and we're going to be extending that over time. So we started a good place. I got to say, it's a great place to relax. As a creative entrepreneur, one of the things you really have to figure out is where is your relaxation time? A lot of entrepreneurs in general just keep working and working and working. And there's a group out there that says, yeah, keep hustling. And they're correct. You got to keep moving. But you also need time to take breaks, to relax, to reset, goal plan, those kind of things. I do a lot of those things while I'm in the Caribbean. And, you know, you think you have it kind of figured out. You kind of have it all set to go. And then you come back to reality and you find out it's not really the way that you thought it was going to be necessarily, or you need to work on those goals. You know, it's kind of like doing the Happy New Year resolutions, right? Where you say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to do. And then after New Year's is over, you actually have to do them. And this is where a lot of the times, a lot of creative entrepreneurs kind of get stuck. And so the same thing happens with us. I do a lot of my goal setting. I'm sitting on the beach, sitting there with a Mai Tai, doing things really cool, enjoying life, and clearing my head is really all that's doing. I'm starting to write down goals, starting to look at goals. But then when I come back in February is when I actually have to get to the work. And a lot of times that can be hard to do. You come back, you're kind of at step one again. And so a lot of times, many times when I'm coming back in February, I'm actually kind of resetting my goals again. So here's what our time looked like. January, we spent it by the beach. Great time to do that. Came back at the beginning of February. Now I do a little bit of work on while I'm away. We're built a lifestyle business, so we actually do work from there. We roughly work half days. We go down for a long period of time, so we're not just, it's not like when you go for a week and you just don't want to do anything. We have to keep working while we're going. So I got some illustration jobs. I got a couple gift caricature projects that came through. Of course, I've always got my podcast. Those are a monthly thing, so I'm always doing editing or recording or whatever. You probably saw I did a podcast interview in Barbados with a team of designers there, photographers. So that was great. Andrew Odell and his teammates, they did a wonderful job. So that's kind of my January. That's normal. We got a real good network of friends, so we spend them down there and then just enjoy our times. But when I get back here is where we have to get back to work. And a lot of times it's either following up on some phone calls of people of what they wanted to do. For my February, I got a logo design right when I got back. So we started doing a logo design for a guy. I had a film shoot to do for a customer. They wanted me to do some video production for them. And so I did we had a film shoot. I was already booked to speak to a young group of entrepreneurs and people coming out of an accounting society, Odette. You're going to hear more about them as we go along. So I was talking, I had that booked with them. And then I ended up deciding to rebrand my studio. So that was probably a big thing for me. It just felt, as your business changes, you need to actually start changing some of that. And what I felt was with the video production we're doing and the podcasts and stuff, as it gets more serious and more in depth and more whatever, we need to change. I wasn't working as efficiently as I was even as a creative entrepreneur. So what I did, rebranding or revising the studio was one of those big things. We did some rebranding in January on one of our trucking podcasts there. So that kept us going. Busy with that stuff. And then I took some time to just revise some goals. And sometimes this is the great way to kind of restart. And the way to do the goals, one of the best things that I found is to not just start doing them, but actually take a day. So what I did is I'm against Valentine's Day, really against it. And so what I did is we skipped Valentine's Day, and then we took the Friday off, and my wife and I had a kind of a date day, and went to see a movie, went to lunch, those kind of things, and just kind of reset. Try not to do any business other than email and a little bit of social media that day, just to kind of restart, reset. And then the next day, and I had already done my goals the day before, so this was just kind of to make it a clean break was the reason for that. And then we started moving with the goals, and so now I'm starting to act on those, prioritize certain ones. What are we doing this week? What are we doing that week? And I always suggest people do that. And then I had a meeting about my television show with the producer, station manager over at Kojiko. And so that's going to be going on, and we're working on how to move forward with that because they had some of their team reduced last at the end of last year. And so now they're looking for the community producers to take on a little bit more of the role from behind the scenes as well as in front. And so we went to talk to Stu about that. So I'm happy to say the show is going to be, keep going on for 2019 at least. And we'll see how things go for the future. But I'm happy to do that. And because I have a lot of the equipment and a lot of the editing tools and stuff that you need, I'll be handling a little bit more of those until they replace that people that let go, if that's what they choose to do. So that's what my February kind of looked like. A lot of starting projects, getting things going. I had a couple events in there, as you know, as a caricature artist. I had a wedding there. So there's a couple events that were in there. And that's kind of the basics of how a creative entrepreneur does it. Now, it depends on the services. We do a lot of different things. But if you think of what we do, we've got my events, okay, which is the caricature events are a big money maker for us. The podcasts are our steady money maker for us. With sponsors on them. And then, you know, the logo designs and the gift caricatures and some of those projects are the ones that just kind of come in and flow and they go out. And, you know, you probably average one or two a week. I don't have any big assignments. I have one or two publications now that I'm doing cartoons for. It's kind of a once a month thing, not really a big deal. So the rest of it is just going in and out. So there's some months where it's busy. And actually, February turns out to be a fairly busy month for us, which is surprising for a lot of entrepreneurs. So if you're a creative, don't necessarily worry. Like, decide on where your money is and keep working around those. There's a lot of times there's phone calls about sponsorships or there's meetings to do, and you're working. Just make sure you're working. This is one of the big things we had to do for our goals, is make sure that we're working in the right way and working on things to do with our with what we want to do, right? So increasing the podcast, make sure if that's where our money's coming in, we're spending our time there. It's really easy, and I do this all the time. I did it last year too, where I take on a lot of stuff because it's slow. You take on a lot of stuff like commitments for the year, and then before you know it, when you get busy, you're having trouble keeping up with those commitments. So be careful that when it's slow like this as an entrepreneur, to not take on too much stuff, to keep your keep things just rolling along, focus on where your income's coming in, and then you'll be a great thing. So I thought this would be helpful for you. I hope you're enjoying this. This is just a bit of lifestyle of the creative entrepreneur, and we'll share these on a monthly basis for you so that you can enjoy them and realize that not everybody is running at 100 miles an hour, or everybody is not just sleeping on the couch. There is in between. And it's good to know kind of what people do and what they do. So we have a different flow in our business as to what happens. Not everybody will be that way. If you don't do podcasts, you wouldn't be doing podcast editing. But hopefully you're filling that time with something else. And that's what makes you a creative entrepreneur.